Alright, so in the previous video we just learned how we can use the TensorBoard logger to visualize the data that is generated during training. In this video we are going to look at an alternative approach using the CSV logger, which is incredibly useful when we are working with notebooks. When I'm working with JupyterLab or Jupyter Notebooks, I personally prefer to create CSV files for my logs so I can actually display or plot them in Matplotlib. This is very convenient if you are teaching or, let's say, exploring data. This is very convenient, for example, if you also want to save your plots as PDF or PNG files, for example, if you are preparing a blog post or a research article. And of course, this is also convenient if you are uploading this notebook on GitHub and you want to share it with others, and others should see the plot inside the notebook. So let's then now see how we can use the CSV logger. So first, of course, we have to import it. So we start with from Lightning PyTorch loggers import CSV logger. We'll also execute the code above just to make sure everything is executed. And then I'm modifying the line here, adding the CSV logger. So I can again specify where it should save the logs. Here I'm just saying, let's save it in a folder called logs next to the notebook here. And I can give my model a name. Let's just call it my model. And that's really it. So let's execute that. So this will train the model now. So yeah, the model stopped training now after 10 epochs, and we can see we reached a good validation set accuracy and a good training set accuracy of 97%. So now the next part is to plot the results. Here I have some rather complicated looking pandas code to visualize the results from this metrics file that was created in this log directory. So if you forgot where your log directory is, you can always use trainer.logger.logdir, which will show you where exactly the logs are. Now using that, there is a metrics CSV file. Here we have some complicated looking code that you don't have to, let's say, fully follow. It's like more advanced pandas stuff. So if you're interested in that, I should probably share some pandas resources for you. But for this notebook, the key idea here is that we are using the CSV logger. So let's maybe not get distracted by the pandas code. Let's just execute it. And we can see with pandas and then matplotlib, where I am calling .plot here, I can visualize the training and the validation set loss. And yeah, as we can see, it goes down nicely over the 10 epochs. So here the index starts at 0. We have the stopping point at 9, so it's 10 epochs, which looks very nice here. It goes down. Maybe training a bit longer would be also good. And we can see the training set accuracy and validation set accuracy, they go up. And we can see maybe if we trained a little bit longer, they would go up a little bit more. Maybe not. Maybe the validation set would start overfitting here. Hard to tell. So yeah, this is an alternative way of visualizing the logs. Of course, there are many, many more tools out there, specialized tools. And if you're interested, I can share more information with you about additional tools. So TensorBoard and CSV loggers are the most basic loggers. However, I think for beginners, they are just great because they are very simple to use and they don't have much overhead.
In this video, we learned how we can use the CSV logger to create log files that we can then display using Matplotlib. This is incredibly useful when we are working with notebooks and we want to share these notebooks with other people.